Welcome, La Bronza viewers and listeners. The recent recognition of a Palestinian state by Spain, Ireland, and Norway is mainly symbolic. This recognition does not specify borders, and it does not lead to any concrete legal binding action or policy changes. This recognition is essentially a reward for terrorism. It is a recognition that rewards Iran and its proxy, Hamas. It legitimizes terrorism and it fully supports terrorism. And this recognition will only lead to further violence and the recurrence of the horrors like those witnessed on October the 7th, 2023. Let us consider Norway's renowned defense company called Nammo. Nammo specializes in producing ammunition, rocket mortars, explosives, and demolition products. Over the years, Nammo has emerged as a major player in the global defense industry, with operations spanning Norway, Sweden, Finland, Germany, Switzerland, Spain, the United States, and Canada. This extensive global footprint enables Nammo to serve a diverse range of customers and a diverse range of markets worldwide. We must note that Nammo is a reputable defense company, and we must note that Nammo does adhere to strict international laws and regulations governing the export of military equipment. These regulations prohibit the sale of arms to entities or countries that are known to support terrorism or are subject to international sanctions. Since Iran, Hamas, and Hezbollah are all designated as entities that support terrorism, supplying them would be illegal and against Nammo's policies and commitments to global security. Nammo does not supply Iran, Hamas, or Hezbollah. And if this is the case, why then would Norway symbolically recognize a Palestinian state that is effectively run by Hamas, Iran's proxy, and is designated as a terrorist organization? It is this recognition that undermines the very principles of counterterrorism and global security that Norway upholds through companies like Nammo. And now let us take a look at Spain. The Prime Minister of Spain, Pedro Sanchez, in a significant political development, demonstrated his opportunist maneuvering on the domestic political landscape. On Thursday, May the 30th, Spain's lower house of parliament approved the amnesty law, granting amnesty to hundreds of Catalan separatists who were involved in the 2017 secession attempt. On October the 1st, 2017, the Catalan government, which was then led by the president, Puigdemont, held an independence referendum despite being declared illegal by Spain's constitutional court. The referendum saw a significant portion of voters supporting independence. Although the turnout was low due to a boycott by those opposed to secession and also because of a police crackdown to stop a vote. But following the referendum on October the 27th in 2017, the Catalan parliament declared independence from Spain, prompting a severe response from the Spanish government. Madrid immediately imposed direct rule over Catalonia. Madrid immediately dissolved the regional parliament, and Madrid immediately called for new elections. Key Catalan leaders were arrested, while others, including Puigdemont, fled abroad to avoid prosecution. The secession attempt brought Spain to the brink of a constitutional crisis, deepening the divide between supporters of Catalan independence and those advocating for Spanish unity. This amnesty law marks a pivotal moment, particularly benefiting former Catalan regional president Puigdemont, who has been living in self-imposed exile in Belgium since the failed October 2017 independence bid. This legislation is expected to extend amnesty to a broad range of individuals, including former government individuals, civil servants, and average citizens who participated in the secession movement or related protests. This move has been seen by many as a tactical decision by the Prime Minister of Spain, Pedro Sanchez, and it comes 6 years since after Catalonia's separatist movement brought Spain to the brink of rupture. Critics argue that Sanchez's actions are driven by self-serving political needs rather than genuine reconciliation, reflecting his opportunist approach to maintain and strengthen his own political standing. In this context, Sanchez's recent announcement regarding Spain's symbolic recognition of Palestine has also drawn skepticism. How can a leader perceived as corrupt and opportunist be trusted to make such significant foreign policy decisions? Sanchez's history of political maneuvering casts doubt on his sincerity and on his integrity of his recent proclamations on the international stage. And last but not least, Ireland's Prime Minister, Simon Harris, also announced that Ireland would recognise the state of Palestine as a viable, sovereign, independent, and democratic state, and even raised the Palestinian flag outside the Leinster House, which is the national parliament in Dublin, Ireland. And also last month, Dublin announced it would officially support South Africa in its case against Israel at the International Court of Justice over its war on Gaza. The irony of such gestures is hard to ignore, given that the conflict in the region remains unresolved and violence continues to claim lives daily. It is as if Ireland is trying to declare peace in a war zone while the bombs are still falling. No one understands better than Israelis what it means to live under the constant threat of annihilation, surrounded by neighbours who are always bent on our destruction. This reality is not a distant historical footnote. It is an ever-present, brutal truth that defines our daily existence. We in Israel have endured decades of terrorism, decades of rocket attacks, decades of suicide bombings, and decades of brutal incursions, all while serving to maintain a semblance of normalcy and hope for peace. The symbolic recognition of a Palestinian state by these countries is not just a failure to address the core issues of the conflict. It is a betrayal that undermines the very efforts needed to combat terrorism. Such actions strengthen Hamas and provide them with legitimacy and further encouragement to continue their violent campaigns. These recognitions send a chilling message to those who have suffered and continue to suffer at the hands of terrorists. These recognitions are an outright betrayal of the victims who were slaughtered, brutally raped, burnt alive, mutilated, and taken hostage on October the 7th, 2023. They make a mockery of the principles of justice and peace. By rewarding violence, these actions destabilize the region further and ensure that the cycle of bloodshed and suffering continues. Instead of genuine peace strategies, these recognitions perpetuate conflict and empower those who thrive on violence and chaos. The international community's symbolic recognitions of recognizing a Palestinian state demonstrate a dangerous ignorance of the realities on the ground. Norway, Spain, and Ireland disregard the daily threats and aggressions faced by Israelis and effectively side with those who seek to destroy us. Your actions pave the way for more bloodshed, more terror, and more heartbreak. Your symbolic recognitions are acts of complicity with the oppressors and the terrorists, Hamas, Iran, and Hezbollah. It is your liberal views of freedom that ensure the cycle of violence and hatred will never end. And instead of standing against terrorism and supporting true efforts for peace, you are inadvertently empowering those who seek to perpetuate conflict and destruction. By legitimizing these violent entities, you are guaranteeing that the bloodshed and suffering will continue, undermining the very principles of justice and peace that you claim to uphold. Israel rightly condemned the symbolic recognitions and rightly recalled its ambassadors from Norway, Spain, and Ireland. We in Israel are determined to attain our goals, to bring our hostages home, to bring security to our citizens, and to dismantle Hamas. There are no goals more just than these. Thank you for listening.